My guest today is Tara Notrika. She is 57 years old and a mum to two children, Jared, 21, and Samantha, 17. She's been married to Barry for 24 years and they live in New York. Prior to becoming ill with a rare disease called mast cell disease, she was a special education teacher administrator. Her disease causes her to have anaphylactic episodes from multiple triggers. Since there is no cure and very few medications for her disease, her transplant doctor and Tara decided to proceed with having a transplant. In July 2015, she had an autologous stem cell transplant using her own stem cells. In June 2018, she had an allogeneic bone marrow transplant from an unrelated donor. However, due to various complications, she was hospitalized extensively at MSKCC in New York City. Her story has been made into a documentary called Second Chance, featuring all original music co-written and recorded by Samantha, her daughter. The full documentary will be available to the public in spring 2020 after it's finished completing the film festival circuit. What does the word unbroken mean to you?
So that's a very good question. And the thing that comes to mind for me is, I'm actually going to start with a little bit of the negative aspect. So my body is semi-broken. However, I feel that my spirit, my resilience, my perseverance, my courage, my strength, and I could go on with those types of descriptive words, I feel those things are not broken. So it started in my 20s, and as the years progressed, I started having more frequent and more severe types of reactions. So my reactions for me would consist of facial swelling, hives, constriction of airways, a lot of gastro symptoms where I would both be throwing up and having diarrhea at the same time. And
both ends. That's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very scary. And then my blood pressure would plummet. So these reactions continued throughout my 20s, 30s. And then I'm going to say after my two pregnancies, that's kind of when things spiraled very much out of control.
And is that a known thing? Can pregnancies impact on the symptoms? Do they have you done research to that?
I'm not really sure if that is the case. You know, there are a lot of hormonal changes when you go through pregnancy and childbirth. So that would be a better question for a medical professional because I can't really answer. I just know, again, in my case, once I had my daughter, who was my second child, it was three times a week that I was having these anaphylactic episodes. And
any warning? Do they just come on, or are you aware that something's happening? Can you recognize signs?
They come on fast and furious. And, you know, you have to intervene. At that point, I was going to the emergency room pretty oftenly. I was treated a lot with IV Benadryl and prednisone and Singulair and sometimes even requiring oxygen, epinephrine. So over time, the treatment course has changed too.
What do the different names mean? What is the difference in these type of stem cell transplants?
One is using your own cells, and the allogeneic is using the cells of a donor. So in my case, it had to be an unrelated donor. My sister would have been the only person that would have been a potential match to me. She was tested, she was not. So they had to go into the donor bank and find a donor for me.
And isn't it amazing there's people there that will donate their cells for this to be able to happen to you, because it's not a pleasant procedure either, is it? They have to go into the bone marrow, I think, don't they?
Yes. They say it's gotten easier. Mm-hmm. I've had quite a few bone marrow biopsies. I'm not sure if that's exactly like the procedure that the donors go through. It's not pleasant,
no.
But they say now it's bearable. I don't think it's as painful as it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
So,
do the procedures get easier? Do you hate them? Or are you just so used to them now?
I'm kind of used to the bone marrow biopsies. Uh-huh. You just like kind of don't think about it. You know, you kind of take your mind away.
Mm-hmm.
Even when I do go in for procedures, you know, everybody always told me positive thoughts. So if I had to go under, the last thing I would always say to the staff in the OR was, one of my favorite places to go to is Disney World.
Mm-hmm.
So I would tell them I'm taking a trip to Disney.
Free pass, I hope.
It kind of, excuse me one second, it kind of helped me get through it.
So that's kind of really visualization in some way, isn't it?
That was my thing. Anytime I went under, I told them I was taking a trip to Disney World, my favorite place.
How did you come across the film producer? Did they contact you or you contacted them?
I contacted him.
Okay. Because I've seen the trailer, and even just the trailer, I'm just about half a second in. My eyes are filling up. It's so emotional. But what is beautiful is Samantha's voice. And the lyrics to the words. Has she always been a songwriter, singer, your daughter?
She's always loved singing.
Mm-hmm.
I remember she's very tall.
Mm-hmm.
She's about 5'7". And I remember during her kindergarten graduation, preschool graduation, they performed some songs up on stage. And she was in the middle
mm-hmm.
of the entire graduating preschool class, and her teacher told me her voice is going to carry, you know, the whole ceremony here. So, yeah, since she's like 5 years old, she's always loved singing and dancing. And, you know, my son is 4 years older than her. So when he was, I think it was fourth grade that he started trumpet lessons, and she decided she wanted to play an instrument too. So she started with lessons in kindergarten. So she plays the alto saxophone.
Oh, wow.
In addition to singing and, you know, the writing, that was a lot of collaborating, you know, pretty amazing considering at the time she was 13 and 14 years old
mm-hmm.
To be thinking about these really powerful things. And so the trailer only shows a clip of the feature song, which is Second Chance, and she actually has won a lot of awards for the song.
I'm not surprised. It's so, so moving and touching.
Yeah. So it's, you know, it's about finding your perfect bone marrow donor and getting a second chance at life. And she actually recorded 9 original songs for the film, which are part of a soundtrack,
mm-hmm.
Dealing with different topics of things that we went through during that time period. So the film has clips of, I think it's like 6 songs. It plays Second Chance in its entirety. And there were 3 that were not included in the film that are part of the soundtrack.
And have you been worried as a mum the impact this has on your kids? I mean, if anything, it sounds like it's had a positive impact. She's kind of, your resilience has rubbed off on her in some ways, but that must have been, I'm a mum of three kids. That must have been a concern, what is it doing to my kids, my family?
You worry, but I used to have a conversation with their elementary school principal. She's since retired. My son is graduating college, my daughter's graduating high school, and I'm still in touch with her. But we spoke about how it could have really been very bad for them. And they could have been very resentful, and they could have really taken a different path. But I think the fact that I just persevered and didn't give up and, took every ounce of strength within me to make it work. I think they saw that and they kind of chose that path.